In this particular video, I'm going to show you how to solve a couple second-order differential equations. First, this is the standardized form for a second-order differential equation. We're going to generalize the terms in front of the second derivative, call it m, the coefficient in front of the first derivative, b, the term in front of the x term, k, forcing function f. In general, this can be represented by a very simple mechanical vibrational system where m is the mass, b is the damping, and k is the spring constant of the system. So we're going to use that physical system to serve as the general equation or the standardized form of the second order differential equation. The homogeneous portion of the second order differential equation, similar to what you have seen in the first order differential equation, is that the right hand side of the differential equation is equal to zero. We can then solve the general homogeneous solutions by assuming the solution being an exponential function, plugging it into the original differential equation, and arrive at the so-called characteristic equation, which is this particular equation, ms squared plus bs plus k. And in order for us to solve this algebraic equation now, using quadratic formula, we can then see that s turns out to be two roots. There are two functions, or actually two numbers for s. And the numbers of s can be determined by the values of mass, spring constant, and the damping coefficient. Again, those are a quick review, since this is something you probably have seen already in your math class. And there are three different type of scenarios for the homogeneous solution based on the condition determined by this particular relation b squared minus 4mk. If that relation turns out to be greater than zero, we call the general homogeneous solution to be an overdamped solution. If b squared minus 4mk is equal to zero, we call the homogeneous solution a critically damped homogeneous solution. If b squared minus 4mk is less than zero, we call the solution an underdamped homogeneous solution. And this is what we know. If you have an overdamped homogeneous solution, both s1 and s2, the roots of the characteristic equation, are negative real numbers, is going to result in the following solution here. And that represents an exponential decaying solution. Here's the exponential part. Since S1 and S2 are both negative, the solution is decaying. And something we're going to talk about later on, that about stability. But we're going to mention it here. The solution is stable right now. Okay? If you have a critically damped homogeneous solution, both S1 and S2 are negative real numbers, but they happen to be the same number. And the homogeneous solution will take this form, which is a ramped function. A ramped function is something with a linear slope, as you can see, something constant times t plus b, multiplied by an exponential decaying solution. Here's the exponential function. This is a decaying portion. Again, this solution is stable. The third case where we have an underdamped homogeneous solution, where the roots to the characteristic equation will take on an imaginary root. So these are complex roots. And the solution, the homogeneous solution, will result in this format. The exponential decaying portion can be seen in this portion of the solution. The sinusoidal the sine wave and the cosine wave are indicating in this part of the solution. And in this particular case, we can define that the sine and cosine function will have this frequency omega d of this equation. And we call this a damped natural frequency. Again, this is something we have talked about in class, so this is a quick review of what is covered in class. Next, I want to show you how do we use all of that we just talked about to solve for an example. So, here's the second order differential equation, and I'm quickly going to write my standard form here on the right hand side. I can quickly identify my constants, m is equal to 2, b is equal to 2, and k is equal to 4. My forcing function f of t is 10. Solution to this differential equation, x, will consist of the homogeneous aspect and the particular solution. Before we determine what the homogeneous solution is, we need to figure out what is and what is my characteristic equation. Okay. So let's go ahead and take a look. B squared minus 4mk . This is definitely less than zero, so we have an underdamped solution. Let's go ahead and solve for my S then. S is equal to minus 2a. Minus 1/2 plus or minus 4 minus 32, right? This is a negative number, so we have an I here. So I'm going to have a minus 1/2 plus or minus square root of 7i divided by 2. Okay? These are my S1 and S2. And from this, I can arrive at my homogeneous solution is the exponential function. Minus t over 2, that's this portion. Multiply by a sine. Here is my damped natural frequency plus b cosine. Okay. Let's go ahead and take a look at my particular solution. My particular solution, we're going to assume that is a constant similar to the right-hand side. So I'm going to assume is going to be a constant C. X double dot P is equal to 0. X dot P is equal to 0. So let's go ahead and plug everything in. We're going to have 0 plus 0 plus 4 times C equal to 10. So C is equal to 10 over 4. Hence, my full solution, this is from the prior slide, sine cosine. We can then go ahead and plug in the initial conditions to solve for B. Okay. One more example. What happened now if I have an additional term over on the right hand side? In this particular case, go take a look at my standardized form. You can see that m is equal to 1, b is equal to 3, and k is equal to 2. Okay, characteristic equation. S squared plus 3s plus 2 is equal to 0. If you go ahead and solve for s, s is equal to minus 2. Minus 1. This is, if you go ahead and check this case, b squared we have an overdamped case. So my homogeneous solution is a exponential function b. Particular solution must be self-similar, so we're going to guess constant sine function or sine and cosine function. As shown in prior cases, whenever you have a sinusoidal function, you must show both cases. Okay? Go ahead and derivative minus d sine t plus e cosine t. Derivative of a constant drops minus d cosine t e sine t. Plug everything into the differential equation. That's the first one. Second one. Must equal to 10. Okay. If we go ahead and collect the cosine term, 1, 2, 3, I'm going to do it here instead of flipping to the second page because it's much easier if I do it over here. You're going to get minus d from the first term plus 3e from the second one plus 2d from the third one equal to 10. Collect the sine term minus e from the first one minus 3d from the second one plus 2e from the third one equal to 0. Collect the constant term, nothing from the first, nothing from the second, 2c equal to 10. You can then solve for c, d, and e. So now we know everything. We now know my solution is exponential function. Homogeneous solution plus the particular C, which we can solve, D need to go back to the prior slide to make sure I'm consistent. D cosine T and E sine T, sorry about that. In the prior slide, we already solved for CDE. Now you can just plug in your initial conditions to solve for A and B. When we solve this using Laplace transform, you will see that it's much easier for us to solve these constants. But this is how you can solve a second order differential equation using the traditional method and the characteristic equation.